இன்னைக்கு நம்ம செவன்த் சாப்டர்ல உள்ள செவன்த் சாப்டர் நம்ம வந்து எல்லாருக்கூடிய இம்பார்ட்டன்ட் ஏரியா கொஞ்சம் ரிவிஷன் பண்ணிக்கலாம். அது ஃபஸ்ட்டு டிஃப்ரென்ஸ் பிட்வீன் த ஆக்டிவ் அண்ட் பேசிவ் இம்யூனிட்டி. ஆக்டிவ் இம்யூனிட்டி பேசிவ் இம்யூனிட்டி எடுத்துட்டோம்னா ஆக்டிவ் இம்யூனிட்டி ப்ரொடியூஸ்டு ஆக்டிவ்லி பை ஹோஸ்ட் இம்யூன் சிஸ்டம், பேசிவ் இம்யூனிட்டி ரிசீவ்டு பாசிவ்லி அண்ட் தேர் இஸ் நோ ஆக்டிவ் லாஸ்ட் பார்ட்டிசிபேஷன் ஹோஸ்ட் பார்ட்டிசிபேஷன். It is produced due to contact with pathogen or antigen, but it is produced due to antibodies obtained from outside. It is durable and effective in production. It is transient and less effective. And immunological memory is present, is no memory. Booster effect subsequent does is principal subsequent. That's less effective. Immunity is effective only after short period. Immunity develop immediately. Difference important nalla paathukenga. Adha pathina secondary lymphoid organ porom. Secondary lymphoid organ or peripheral lymphoid organs appdin eduthumna. In secondary or peripheral lymphoid organs, antigen is localized so that can be effectively exposed to mature lymphocyte. The best example are the lymph node, appendix, hair patches of gastrointestinal tract, tonsil, adenoid, spleen, malt, mucosal associated lymphoid tissue, galt, cut associated lymphoid tissue, malt, bronchial, ட்ரக்கியல் அசோசியேட்டட் லிம்பாய்ட் டிஷ்யூ இஸ் தி பெஸ்ட் எக்ஸாம்பிள் ஆஃப் த செகண்ட் லிம்பாய்ட் ஆர்கன். த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் லிம்ஃப் நோட், லிம்ஃப் நோட் இஸ் ஸ்மால் பீன் ஷேப் ஸ்ட்ரக்சர் அண்ட் இஸ் பார்ட் ஆஃப் த பாடி இம்யூன் சிஸ்டம். இட் இஸ் த ஃபர்ஸ்ட் ஒன் டு என்கவுண்டர் த ஆன்டிஜன் தட் என்டர் த டிஷ்யூ ஸ்பேசஸ். லிம்ஃப் நோட் ஃபில்டர் அண்ட் ட்ராப் த சப்ஸ்டான்ஸ் தட் ட்ராவல் த்ரூ த லிம்பாட்டிக் ஃப்ளூயிட். They are packed tightly with the white blood cells, namely lymphocyte and macrophages. There are hundreds of lymph nodes found throughout the body. They are connected one another by the lymph vessels. The lymph is a clear, transparent, colorless, mobile and extracellular fluid connected tissue. As the lymph perculate through the lymph node, the particulate antigen brought about by the lymph will be trapped by the phagocytic cells and also follicular interdigitating dendritic cells. They are also trapped by the trapped antigen. So observe the diagram. Efferent lymphoid vessels, afferent lymphoid vessels, and mantle zone and follicle cortex paracortex area, medullary cords, so lymph node has three zones. There are cortex, paracortex and medulla. The outermost layer of the lymph node is called cortex, which consists of B lymphocyte, macrophages and follicular dendritic cells. The paracortex zone is beneath the cortex area, which is richly populated by the T lymphocyte and interdigitating dendritic cells. The innermost zone that are called medulla, which is sparsely populated by the lymphocyte, but many of them are plasma cells, which are actively secrete the antibody molecule. As a lymph enter, they slowly percolate through the cortex, paracortex and medulla, giving sufficient chance of phagocytic cells and dendritic cells to trap the antigen brought by the lymph. The lymph leaving a node carrier enriched antibodies secreted by the medullary plasma cells against the antigen enter the lymph node. Sometimes visible swelling of lymph node occur due to the active immune response and increased concentration of the lymphocyte. So this is swelling. Next, what is known as hypersensitivity? Some of the individuals are very sensitive to some particles present in the environment. The aggregated response of the immune system to certain antigen present in the environment that is called allergy. Allo means alerted, erect means reaction. So the substance to which such an immune response is produced are called allergens. An allergen is an antigen that causes the allergic reaction. So allergic reactions begin with few seconds after the contact with the allergen and last about an half an hour. Common example of the allergens are mite, dust, pollen and some proteins in insect we know. Hay fever and asthma are some common example of the allergy. Symptom of the allergic reaction include sneezing, watery eyes, running nose, and difficulty in breathing. Allergy is a form of overactive immune response mediated by IgE and mast cell. It can also be due to the release of chemical like histamine, serotonin from the mast cell. The next one, anaphylaxis, is classical immediate hypersensitivity reaction. It is a sudden and systematic severe and immediate hypersensitivity reaction occurring the result of rapid generalized mast cell degranulation. Okay, thanks, students.